Well, hey boys, I'm back. It's Eve. We're in space, and we're still in the same place we were, though things have changed dramatically, as happens when you don't, you know, record an update for a long time. But I got a little burnt out on the game. I was sick of doing all the bashing, and it was weird with our corp when we moved out here. I think we moved a little too soon, and we had all been a little too active for a little too long. But for whatever reason, our corporation has slowly died. All of our active members have left, and we still have 46 members, all of them either alts or just AFK for months at a time. So for whatever reason, people aren't logging on anymore. It's been the case that our corp chat has had one or two people in it at any given moment. Our CEO hasn't logged in over a month. Our POS station ran out of fuel and was bashed by some pirates recently, and I can't bring it online long enough to take the rest of the modules down, so it's all pretty fucked. However, I'm going to be leaving the corp, and I've already made my farewells and severances and things like that. But I'm not going to be leaving BNI, because I like it here. I like it in Catch. I've already got all my stuff set up, and I enjoy the company, and some of these guys are pretty damn cool. So I'm going to be staying here. We're going to make a quick trip to GETAC to drop off some of my more movable, contacty, important stuff. I've already moved all of my blueprints and things over to Agile for safekeeping. I wasn't sure for a while there whether I was going to stay or go to HiSec or whatever, so I just dropped them off in Agile. Don't have any production stuff going on right now. All my PIs on hold. I ended up not too interested in PI. It's kind of okay for making passive money, but I don't know about that. So I've been doing some other things. But for now, what we're going to do is probably take this over to GETAC and dump off some of this stuff. So what I'm doing, as far as my corporation status is confirmed, is right now I'm still in Derp Corps. I'm dropping my roles. I have to wait 24 hours, and then I'll be joining an alliance member of the Hero, or actually of Brave Collective, called Brave Provisions, which is similar to Derp Corps in that they are mostly an industrial mining planetary interaction building and production and economic stuff. And so I will probably fit right in over there with those guys. They've been looking for more miners, and here we are. So a bunch of our guys have been going over there. So in a way, Derp Corps will live on through them. What's nice is that Brave really did give us a chance to stay together as a corp without ever implying any need for us to actually, you know, leave our corp and join some other corp. It happened naturally, so I guess that's good for everybody, because that's one less corp they have to deal with, and we get to join an already existing and established corp and move in with them. So I'll be able to continue doing my silly PvP raids and whatnot with my bros from Brave, including Captain Plump, who I have not seen in a while because I haven't been playing very much, but I'm looking to get back into playing more frequently. Oh, by the way, there's been a patch, and there's new cloaking animations, some of them which are pretty damn cool. Yeah, it's been a while. I have been logging on a little bit recently to take care of some business that had to be attended to as far as shutting down my aspects of corp control. So I've been doing that, and I did the best I could to keep people together and interested. I ran, you know, some special programs to try to make it profitable for people to continue to live out here, but it just wasn't working. So I'm gonna be happy to be a small cog in a machine in which, that's a leopard. Oh, this is not good. Oh, if this is AXTAC, it is not AXTAC. Oh, crap. AX dot. Oh, he found me. I'm so dead! Turn on your hardened thingy. I think I have an inertial stabilizer or something. Why isn't he targeting me? What a weirdo. Did he just cloak? He's probably trying to beat me to the gate. Maybe I can make it to the... There's a warp gate in AX dot. I should have taken the warp gate. Maybe. It's arguable. There's a warp gate. Oh, no. I could have taken the one in AOK. There's some changes coming up in the next patch, by the way, involving jump gates that are going to be important for people living out in this particular area of Nullsec. So I don't know all of the changes, so I don't want to talk about them too much, but from what I understand, there's going to be something called jump fatigue, and people who use jump bridges are going to have to deal with having jump fatigue. Anyway, I think this guy's going to kill me over here, which is not that big a deal. I don't think most of the stuff I have in here is very valuable. He hasn't uncloaked. Do I go for a GE TAC? He might not even... I don't even know what a leopard is. I think it's a bomber. Anyway, I've this whole time I've been training skills and such, which is cool. I've got some important new abilities, like the ability to overheat things. I can overload them, and they will catch on fire and burn out and die, like me! Although, I mean, I did burn out for a little while, but the thing you gotta do is when you burn out, take a break, come back. Also, don't sever connection completely, keep in contact with people, that kind of stuff. So now that we're back, we're gonna have to do some changes geographically. The guys we're gonna be, or I'm gonna be merging with, are based out of, I believe they're based out of BuzzDB. This could be a bad warp. I don't know if the station's camped or anything like that. I haven't seen anything about it. Nope. People said newts on GE on dock, but no bubbles. Oh, hey, it's Sanchez. They're expanding their borders, I hear. Did you know? Anyway, we're going to have a little bit of stuff to move. I've given away a lot of the stuff that I had, so I'm losing a little bit of money in this process. If I had carefully sold everything, that would have been one thing. But I mostly just want to make myself nice and mobile, you know, because when things have fallen apart once, they're liable to fall apart again. I'm not trying to be negative or anything like that. But and it looks like we're going to a stable place, but you gotta, when you're a hobo, you gotta live like a hobo. And right now I'm a hobo. I'm just waiting the 24 hours to drop my corporate roles before I join. I don't know if I mentioned this before, but oh yeah, Brave Provisions. I should look them up and show you their corp. It is here. Sword and Stars fits in with the collective. An industrial corp, providing your members with ever-growing blah, 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 blah. They got about 150 people, so I won't have to be thrown in an alliance chat with like 6 billion people. Or maybe I will. I guess not a corp chat then. So that's good. And here's all the stuff we're keeping, and I'm just going to toss this in the item hanger here. We've got a Caracal and a Moa here, and this is our Iteron, which I don't even know what it's fitted with, but a little bit of transport, but that's mostly what's going to be here at GETAC. I've got another Caracal and some other ships I'm going to want to move out of BTAC, but those are probably not going to be until later. So I'm going to go ahead and make this unloaded haul all the way back to BTAC. Wow. That was a big ship. It left. Looks like somebody had some fun out here. There were wrecks and things, but they've been looted. Filthy whores. So yeah, I'm gonna make that little transport, and then I'll update a little bit more on what's been going on with my character, personally. Which is some cool stuff. I've learned some new cool abilities. And I've got a new ship to fly, too. On my way back, I picked up the rest of my planetary interaction stuff, because I'm going to let these Farmville planetary interaction fields go fallow for a little while, until I'm sure about where I'm living. I'm going to be taking it easy, and not getting too day-to-day with Eve for a little bit, because I want to ease my way back into it without getting burnt out again. I'd like to get more into fleets, though, and do a little PvP, which is weird that I'm joining a industrial corp. But I'm not going to worry too much about it. Anyway, I've already given away most of the ore from our corporation buyback program, which I funded myself. So I gave that stuff away because it wasn't really part of my actual sort of income wallet money that I had earned. And then I'm going to be giving away all of this planetary interaction stuff as well. I had intended to use that to produce fuel for the corporation, but, well, there's no corporation anymore. So, yeah, I'll be adding that to the stuff that I'm giving away. The rest of this stuff I'll be throwing into a contract to a dude out here in Catch that does salvage reclaiming, but through contract management, where you can throw him basically everything in your inventory or whatever, into a contract for him, and he'll buy it back for about 90% Jita prices. So that's pretty damn good. About the best you can get out here, especially when you don't have to go through all the hassle of shipping and then selling each individual item. I've heard that the next patch has something for multi-selling options, but it's going to be wonky on first release, and I just need to get my stuff down to a manageable level. I'm going to have to figure out which of these ships I want to keep with me, but for now, I just wanted to show you what we had actually accomplished with our planetary interaction, about 170 million ISK. There was quite a while there that I was not doing it at all. I just didn't log in because I was just burnt out. But I did run it for a couple of weeks. Not bad numbers. Anyway, that's all going away. We should, by the time all this stuff is contracted and sold, we should have somewhere around 750 million ISK, maybe a billion if I sell some of the ships. But that's where we're going to be. And I'll be back in a bit to show you my new toy. Okay, my everything container is empty. I can't repackage it even. I don't even know why. The other one, it let me repackage. I can't trash it, so it's just going to have to be here for a while. But that's everything liquidated and moved out already. That's pretty good. Except for a couple of ships, including my new toy. We can now fly Kaldari Interceptors. This is a crow. And it is a very fast, sexy little ship. Right now I'm training Interceptors 4. We've already trained a number of skills in the meantime that I've been away. Also, one of the reasons I've been away a little bit is because I've been sick. You can probably hear it in my voice. I'm a little sick right now, which is the best time to play Eve. Anyway, I left right about here, or here. And since then we've trained, so we got that. That's Tech 2, Shield Hardeners. Yeah, I think that I covered that. Signature analysis is targeting speed, target management is targeting numbers, hull upgrades, that's damage control 2, biology, that means I can take drugs, capacitor management, good for other tech, power grid management, more fitting and tech skills, thermodynamics, very cool, long range targeting, just general good stuff. I don't know why I trained, I trained energy pulse weapons because I fitted out a destroyer for the pirate day with a bunch of pulse weapons on it that got insta-fragged after I team-killed someone. Anyway, trained Kaldari Frigate to 5, evasive maneuvering 5, interceptors 1, 2, 3, long-range targeting 4, contracting 1, that was a little bit to help me clear out my stuff, and then right now we're training interceptors 4, so basically 3 days left on that. I probably won't train Interceptors 5 right away. What I'll probably go into next are missile skills, so that we can get up to Tech 2 launchers. Now, things have changed a little bit in the launcher world. For some reason, during this last patch, they changed the way that light missile launchers work. There's no longer, like, limited Limos and Arbalest and stuff like that for light missile launchers. There are still for medium and heavy. For some reason, they just changed light, maybe as a test bed. But if you look at light missile launchers, now there's only four kinds. Light, Ample, Compact, and Tech 2. So, before, there were some launchers that were so good that they were just as good as Tech 2. And you could essentially pay more money to get a Tech 2 launcher. And this is the case with, if you look at like rapid light missile launchers, you look at the Arbalest missile launcher, I believe. These things are about 1.5 million, whereas Tech 2s are 900,000. And they require a great deal of fitting skills, but their rate of fire, 6.24 versus 6.24. So you could essentially pay more to get Tech 2 launchers, but that's not the case anymore. The Ample and Compact, they have a 13.6 rate of fire, I believe, on both of them. Yeah. And then the regular light missile launcher has a 16-second rate of fire, but the light missile launcher 2 has a 12.8-second rate of fire. And there's different missile capacity for each one, but and slightly different fitting. There's other numbers there, but that's one of the changes that's been made recently. Anyway, it's very worthwhile now, I believe, to get a Tech 2 launcher, even if you can't fire Tech 2 missiles yet. So I'll be training probably for the 9 days following the Interceptors 4 to get a light missile launcher Tech 2 and put it on my crow. Also, we can now use some longer range targeting thingies. My fitting right now is not too bad. The one thing I want to change is I want to turn this sensor booster 1 into a sensor booster 2, which we can now use, I believe. Yes, we can now use sensor booster 2s. That'll be really nice. That'll bump our targeting range when activated up to like 70 kilometers, 75 maybe? Something like that, depending on whether it's overheated or not. Anyway, right now I've got it fitted for transporting stuff and flying around in NullSec with a couple of oops PvP items on there in case I get into some shit. But I don't know if this is, you know, this is just an experimental build. It doesn't have any defensive capabilities other than gotta go fast. And it does that. Check this motherfucker out. Not only does it go fast, but as an added trait to just the interceptor ship, what's really nice is that it's immune to interdiction spheres, warp disruption fields, mobile, small, medium, and large warp disruptors. It's not immune to being scrambled, but it's immune to a lot of different static camping mechanics, so you can get through a bubble camp very easily in one of these things because they just don't give a fuck. I don't know what that has to do with intercepting, but I'm okay with it. Anyway, when I'm just cruising along normally, this thing will cook at around 621 meters per second, flip on the micro warp drive, and we go up to 3900 meters per second, which is okay, but you overload that motherfucker, like, so, and, come on, why isn't it overloading? Go. Oh, I just turned it off. Turn on overload. Come on, girl. I think I might be lagging out. What's happening? I gotta go fast, ship. Go faster. Be a red one. There we go. Bam. 5,500 meters per second. And we're pretty agile, too. This is the overheat bar, the heat status. If I let it go over a certain amount, it'll start damaging the modules, all of my mid-slot modules. So it would damage my scrambler, disruptor, sensor booster, etc., and the micro warp drive. But already we've gone 200 kilometers away from the station, just fucking around like that. And in fact, I did somehow damage this thing. I thought I turned off my overheat. Is it still on? No. I don't know. Something was going on there. I think I might have been lagging. It doesn't really matter, though. I can get it repaired really quickly. And if you carry nanite paste, you can repair stuff on the fly, which is something I'm going to have to get more familiar with. But I can overheat any of these modules here, so if I get into PvP, I'll have a slight edge over people who can't do that, and just, you know, standard, regular goodness when I'm doing normal flying, and that applies to any ship at all, too. But this is my new toy, my Interceptor, which will be fun for doing little frigate fleets and things like that. It gives me an actual tackle ship, which is not just a throwaway, tackle you for 5 seconds and die kind of ship. In theory, this thing could tackle something difficult to tackle and keep it held for a little while before it died, which is nice. And it insures well, too, and I think it pays out like 12 mil. It's about a 20 million-ish call, something like that. So all in all, pretty good. And because we're out here in Null, it's free to repair, which is awesome, which makes everybody overheat everything. So yeah, bonuses on that department. If I do need to get into a fight, I'll have something to fight with, and goddamn, she's pretty. She's pretty. See, the only thing we have left to do is figure out what to do with our procurer, which I want to keep, and fly. It's got really good drone capacity, decent ore hold. It's designed for, you know, mining and offloading quickly. It's designed to be pretty tanky. And I want to take that with us wherever we're going. This is my ratting caracal. It's fitted with, I think, heavy assault missiles. Yeah. It's okay. Its fitting is decent, I guess. I don't even remember how I had it fitted. I guess just for max resists and whatnot and doing deeps, which are not very good. But we've got another caracal over in our staging system, GE-TAC, which is a rapid light missile caracal, and that's much better for PvP. So this is sort of a PvE ship, and I don't even know if I want to keep it at all. I'll probably transfer it down to GE-TAC and just have it available for if I want to run it on a fleet or something like that, or maybe I'll move it to whatever system I end up moving to in the end anyway. But for now, we're gonna just call it good with this setup. I don't think I have anything else left to do for this particular portion of the day. If I find a fleet, I'll probably go join it. If not, no big deal. Hopefully I'll be integrating with the Brave Provisions guys tomorrow, and we can get to know them and do some stuff, maybe even go mining and stuff like we did in the old days. I would really like to get into a more stable situation with industrial mining and production and things like that. And it'll be important, too, because I've heard rumors that there is a war a-brewing. I mentioned the changes to the jump gate system, and why that's such a big deal out here is that the fatigue you get is, I believe, based off of the distance from an NPC station, or HiSec, mostly, to the area that you're doing your jumping. So, places up in these areas over here, Placid, Black Rise, Vale of the Silent, Tribute, Pure Blind, Geminate, those ones are going to be okay to do jump bridges in because they're so close to HiSec. But Catch is separated from HiSec by Providence. It's not that bad. In fact, I don't even know. Like I said, I don't know all the details. But I know that the area in particular that we might be moving to, which I believe is down here somewhere, BuzzDB, yeah, where Bovril hangs out, as well as Brovi, Brave Provisions, the corp that we're thinking about joining, would need to learn some new jump bridges. But the thing about the jump bridges is it's going to be a whole different ball game. Oh, that's a crooked-ass little line there. And hey, I broke the map for a second. Oh, it went away. So yeah, things will change in that regard. There is a new jump bridge, though, from AOK to somewhere near GETAC, which is pretty nice. Oh yeah, it goes to VTAC 3 or something, I don't know. But I'm just going to have to be happy with finding a new corporation and a new home. The thing about the war brewing, though, is that it may be that because of these changes to the jump bridges, it will be more difficult for people to defend their sovereignty. Particularly people like Brave, who do not have well-established chains of... Well, I don't know. I don't mean to judge because I don't know what their logistical chains are like. So, how can I say whether or not they're well-established? But the idea that anybody out here, which is N3, is going to have a hard time moving stuff using jump freighters and jump bridges, whereas people over here, this is CFC, is not... means that these areas are going to be harder to defend. Everything over here is, in theory, going to be harder to defend, whereas some of this stuff over here, the core of CFC, although this stuff, I don't know, and this stuff down here, maybe not, but the core parts of CFC will be very easy to defend. So the idea is that what will probably happen is that against all authorities who live out here in the NPC space known as Stain, will probably, they used to own Catch, they will probably try to take it back after the patch, in theory. But again, I'm not part of any big intelligence network, I don't know what's going on. I'm just relaying rumors for people who are EVE laymen and who aren't part of the system already. I'm sure that any normal player who never even goes out to NullSec probably knows more about this than I do, but that's what I've heard. And so being part of an industrial alliance during the build-up to war could be nice. It could also be horrifying if we lose the war. But like I said, I'm living the hobo life right now. Well, here we are. This is going to be our temporary home for a while. We'll be based out of a couple of places, or I will anyway. I'll have some of my stuff here in 5TAC and TUI. As well as there's another station... bearing system, which is a bit chaotic down here somewhere. I need to find... Here it is. BuzzDB is right here. This one. Unfortunately, BuzzDB is very chaotic and combat-y, so it's not recommended for us, so I'll probably leave my mining ships up here in N2E. And I'll move some of my combat ships and other stuff down there into Buzz so that I can help out with defense fleets and things like that. But this place is nice. It's got a lot of belts. A decent amount of belts. There's a nearby system, JA, that has, like, a full list of belts. But this one does have an ore anomaly in it as well. small asteroid cluster, decent ratting and stuff. So I think that this is going to be my home station for now. Plus, it's got access to some really solid jump bridges. This jump bridge map, now that I'm in the actual Alliance, is sick. Look at that. Oh, that's dope. I don't know if that's from a patch or if that's from being in the real Alliance or whatever. But either way, we're in Brave Provisions now, and I'm going to be getting some stuff moved, and then we'll get on to actually playing Eve, hopefully. That'd be nice, right? Right? There we go. We're done. And now, we've got a couple of ships here. Nothing moved in the item hangar. Most of my stuff's still in GE TAC in the staging pos for the system, which is fine. I have better access to it now because of the jump bridges from 5N, I can get over to YHN and then just go straight to to GE TAC, which is really nice. Or I can move this other jump bridge down here to get to BuzzDB through... Or wait, no. Yeah, I can go one system up to J... There's jump bridges everywhere. This is a really nice area for bridges. It goes through Quetz. Quetz and Buzz are gnarly for combat, from what I understand. Let me go ahead and pull up my list of... Let's see how many ships have been destroyed in the last hour. Buzz looks like the hot one for now, and not very much. One ship, nice. 24 hours? Oh, that's just escape pods. Wow. That's not as bad as, not as bad as 3GD. But still, not quite as quiet as it was in our previous home. So the thing that I think I'm gonna do now... is probably go take my procurer down to Buzz and buy some ice harvesters and go through UCG. There's an ice belt in there, and I believe there is a POS, a corp-owned POS there. So I can mine ice in there and store it in the POS and ship it out later, which is really actually quite handy. The other thing about Brave Provisions is that they used to be a wormhole corp, and I think they have plans to go back to that at some point, barring any kind of, you know, insanity with Sovereignty. If there is insanity with Sovereignty, we've basically just moved closer to it. Holy fuck. What happened over there? Someone had some fun. 301 escape pods destroyed. That's more than none. Anyway, if the bad men come to kill us, this is where they will come from, Stain. So that means that we'll be a little bit closer than we would have been otherwise. They'll come through an essential area, DSS, which is here. Fortunately, there's a nice choke point there, but it'll be also with assistance from Providence and possibly from CFC. So if the CFC do come, they will come through our area. And you can see that this area over here is essentially CFC controlled, despite it being technically in catch. So yeah, that's a bit complicated, but I think that's what we're going to do is we're going to take our... procurer over to JA TAC and then bounce over to Quetz, and I don't know, I'll just fly up while I talk. Right now it's fitted out for regular mining. I know that there are ice harvesters on sale in Buzz, so I'll probably do that if I don't die en route, which means I should strip my solo YOLO strip miner off of here. I don't know if I should put a damage control on this. I don't think I should. I don't know if this fits even normal, but it seems to work okay. Anyway, time for some jump bridging. This is going to be really weird when the jump bridge change comes into play. Why is it showing my... Oh, wow. Wizardry. I thought it was showing my crow for a second, and I think it might have been. Anyway, the nice thing is that now that we're out of BTAC, I don't have to worry about the hallway of death in between BTAC and GE, and I don't have to also... I think this is the one I wanted to go to. I probably should have paid more attention. Yes, JA. I also don't have to fly through all of the bubbles in AOK from Test being bubble-crazed over there. They just love bubbles, man. They fucking... They're bubbles everywhere. Every time I go through there, I post this image as I'm flying through the bubbles. Just ranting and raving about testing their stupid bubbles. But yeah, I think it'll be nice to get some ore mining going, or ice mining going on, and I know that there's good belts in Buzz, and I'll probably get a procurer for staying there in whatever UCG, and then I'll probably get one to stay up in 5-Tech N, to have a little bit of a spread out availability. I've got an extra crow stored at GE right now. We dropped down to about 600 mil ISK. I think we had up to about 750. My contract with Cool Beans still hasn't been accepted. I don't know exactly how much money that's going to net me. I don't know if it even will net me anything. I mean, he may not even buy it. At which point I'd have to do a bunch of random ass annoying shipping. So I really hope he does buy it, even for like 5 ISK. Come on, Cool Bean, I need you. Fuck off! Sanchez, stop expanding your borders. So, this is Quetz, and in here, and in Buzz, we should find mostly Bovril Borers, the Blood Miners. They are another industrial corp, however they are much larger, and they're known for being scary and mean, which is awesome. It's nice to have big, scary, mean neighbors to scare off the bad men. Plus, if the shit hits the fan and we need to go fight, we'll have someone to fight with. So things are not quite so bad. Quetz is occasionally mentioned horrifically on Intel, but it seems to be pretty quiet right now. Hopefully Buzz will be the same. I've never been to this system before. I think it'll be, yeah, fairly large number of people. There is a station here I need. That new decloaking animation is really cool. If you played it backwards, it would look like you were being eaten by ice. Yum. And we're heading in to do some ice mining. There's going to be some rats here, I assume, so it's a good thing we brought our tanky-ass procurers, although I need to repair my hardeners. I don't know how that or when that happened, but whatever. We should be able to kill them with our drones, I think. It's so blue and pretty. See, I brought a couple of heavies. Probably launch those first so I can get them out. And where are the bad guys? There they are. Wow, that targeting range is not good. We will mine the rats. Man, that's a lot of ice. Not so tough now, are you, stupid rats? Now that I have a spaceship with guns, although I don't exactly do a lot of damage, plus this thing's got pretty paltry range, but it's fast. I did it! I saved everyone! I'm a hero! The world can continue rotating upon its axis. I have saved everyone. I'm gonna go get my mining ship now and hit some fucking ice. It's been a while since I've done any mining. This is going to be nice, even if I don't know exactly what to mine. Enriched, clear, icicle, glare, crust, dark glitter. Dark glitter is one of the rarest of interstellar ices, formed only in areas with large amounts of residual electrical current. Little is known. Sorry. I don't know which one to mine. Help. Icicles, or crust, or glitter, or other glitter. This guy's mining icicles. Enriched icicles. Is there any super rare small ones I should find here? Crystallos. It sounds like something that people pop in nightclubs. I'm gonna go for the Crystallos because I want to pop it. Bottles. The small ones are the most. See, I knew it. Crystallos. Although that one's pretty far away, so I think I'm lazy, and this thing's range is 10 kilometers, so I think I'll go for Glare Crust instead. Fuck it. Whoa, look at that. That thing looks weird. This is insane. What do? So much new things. Oh my god, content. Anyway, now that we're doing something, time to launch Netflix and go AFK. Well, I did my ratting and my ice mining. We got a fair bit of ore. Decent. I mean, the ore comes in small groups, but it's valuable. Each one of these is worth a fair amount of money, so... Made a decent clip of about 10 mil in a couple hours. Not even that. Like an hour. Mostly, I spent the time clearing out rats. There's a lot of rats at that belt. Anyway, got a chance to talk to the new, intelligence section of the corp and find out what's going on with the wormholes and the stratops and, you know, industrial stuff. And it looks like we've got some cool stuff on the horizon, possibly even some scary stuff, I don't know. But, either way, I'm excited and I'm happy to be playing Eve. What a time to be alive! Hopefully we'll have a better idea of what we'll be doing to help the corp out in the future, but it's all the news that's fit to print. And I'm going to log off here in a bubble so I can go be safe and happy with me.